normal function of the kidney. Now you have to assess whether the kidney is functioning normally or not. So here, to know that, we have to know the part of the SKT system which is functioning, either the glomerular or tubule. Then we will switch to examine the blood and serum examination and urine analysis. We have discussed the clearance test. The clearance tests are of different types. These clearance tests help us to know whether the kidney is performing its function normally at the level of the glomerulus. Inulin, I told, it is the best method to identify or to determine the glomerular filtration rate. Regarding that, another substance we use for clearance test, that is the creatinine, the same formula as we discussed in the inulin. That means creatinine value concentration is equal to urea creatinine value multiplied by volume of the urine and divided by the plasma concentration of the creatinine. Normal value we get male, in case of the male, 97 to 137 ml per minute, and in case of female, 88 to 128 ml per minute. But the value, usually the glomerular filtration rate is 125 ml per minute. And here the slight variable value we are getting, that means in the increased value. Urea clearance test we also do. Here we select 2 1-hourly urine samples. Then we collect the blood at the end of the first hour, and the urea content of the blood is calculated, or rather estimated, in mg percentage. In the urine sample, we have to determine the concentration of the urea in mg percentage, and the urinary output per minute is to be calculated. So these four calculations, we have to put the value in the same formula. That means clearance of the urea is equal to urine urea multiplied by volume of the urine in ml per minute and divided by urea in mg per 1 ml of plasma. Here actually there are two type of the things we observe. One is the maximum clearance, another is the standard clearance. These value, two values are not found in other, in inulin and creatinine. The maximum clearance means that if the urinary output of the urine, if the minute output of the urine be 2 ml or more, then it is called the maximum clearance. Here we get the normal value about average 15 ml per minute. Maximum clearance means if the urinary output per minute be 2 ml or more, then it is called the maximum. Normal value, average we get 15 ml per minute. Now we have to get the percentage efficiency. We have assumed that 75 ml as 100% efficiency. So if we put the value in the concentration of the urea, that means Cu into 100 by 75, that is Cau into 1.33%. So if one has the concentration value is 50 ml, then we get the percentage value by multiplying the value of 50 ml and 1.33, as we have considered that 75 ml is equal to 100%. This way, if the minute output of the urine be less than 2 ml or 2 ml is called the standard clearance. That means, in the short form, it is called the C small s in the lower case. Normal value is about 54 ml per minute. This value is directly proportional to the filtration rate, and you have to note it down. So these are the three clearance tests: inulin, creatine and urea. Out of that, most effective value we get by finding the inulin clearance, and that is about 125 ml per minute. Now we have to find out where the tubules are secreting normally or not. To that, it is to be estimated as tubular maximum. Tubular maximum is expressed in the term T to the power, not to the power, to the power lower case, say M. The value of, to find out this value, we select another substance. As in the previous test, we select the inulin, creatinine and urea. Here we select the substance that is PAH. The full form is the para-aminohippuric acid. This value will help us to know the secretory and excretory efficiency of tubules. Tubules has got the two parts, two function. One is the secretion, another is the excretion. So these two function of the tubules are to be found out by this value. Procedure here: PAH, that means the para-aminohippuric acid, is injected, and then we have to find out how much amount is filtered and how much amount is excreted in the urine. Then there is a calculation. Here the calculation is TPH. TPH means transport of the pH is equal to urinary pH minus F. TPH is the maximum tubular pH. UPH is equal to urinary pH excretion, and F is equal to the amount of the pH filtered. The value is TMPH is equal to 80 mg per minute. The plasma pH value is about 18 mg, higher than the GFR. It means that when plasma pH value is more than 20 mg per dl, TMPH value is achieved at this plasma pH value. Next, we have to find out whether there is a renal blood flow is normal or not. To find out the renal blood flow is normal or not, it is to be estimated by PAH clearance. The formula is urinary pH into V divided by arterial pH. Here we are getting to find out the pH concentration in the artery and pH excreted in the urine and the volume. Usually the value becomes 0.02 mg per ml. And the effective renal pressure flow is about 700 ml per minute. So renal blood flow also help us to detect whether the kidney is functioning normally or not. The blood and serum examination of urea, creatinine, albumin and albumin-globulin ratio is to be done by the auto analyzer method. Now we have to go through the last, that is the urine analysis. Here we have to find out the normal constituents of the urine and abnormal constituents. This urine analysis includes the physical examination and the chemical examination and microscopical examination. The physical examination includes the color. Normal color of the urine is about is pale yellow or amber color, that is due to the presence of a pigment that is called urobilinogen. The reaction is usually clear and acidic. pH value is ranged from 4.5 to 8.2. The specific gravity 1.010 to 1.050. The turbidity, freshly voided urine is transparent, clear. But if that urine is kept for a time being in a test tube, it will be seen, it will be changed to the cloudy due to precipitation of the calcium phosphate. Water is usually faintly aromatic due to the presence of the number of volatile organic substances. Now, there are certain concentration of the urine in organic substances which are excreted in the urine. Some organic substances are there which are also excreted in the urine. Their value is very less, but we have to know how much amount is excreted per day. Urea is usually excreted about 25 to 30 gram per day normally. Ammonia 0.7 gram per day normally. All the values are in above, means it is not the fixed, it is changeable. Creatinine about 1.2 to 1.7 gram per day. Oxalate about 10 to 30 milligram per day. Amino acid about 150 to 200 milligram per day. Hippuric acid about 0.7 gram per day. Chloride about 6 to 9 gram per day. Sodium chloride about 10 to 15 gram per day. Phosphate about 0.8 to 1.3 gram per day. And calcium about 0.1 to 0.3 gram per day. Magnesium about 0.1 to 0.2 gram, very less amount are being excreted. Potassium 2.5 to 3.0 and sodium about 4 to 5 gram per day. So these are the normal concentration of the substances as it is present in our body, but very small amount is excreted. If it is toxic, the excretion amount will be more. If it is useful substance, the excretion will be less. Abnormal, certain abnormal constituents will get if a person being in disease. Protein, very less amount, that is called traces, is excreted per day. Glucose, about 140 milligram per day is excreted in the urine normally. Remember it. But it doesn't mean the person is suffering from any other disease condition. Ketone bodies, acetone, beta hydroxybutyric acid and other ketone bodies about 3 to 15 milligram per day excreted. Ketone bodies are normally not formed in a body. If the person is the disease, then the ketone bodies form. The blood not normally present but abnormal. Bile salt, bile pigments, calculi, the stones are there. Calculi means the stone. If the stone is passed in the urine, so it will be found the cast, the fast cells and the hormones. So this is all about the kidney function test. You may have a long question on the kidney function test. So you have to discuss this way. Okay.